Why spend money on these crap teams that can't play football with crap players when it can be spent on a national team?
Basically, that local team. You know, they're only 10 minutes down the road, so it's easy, convenient for me to go down there on Saturday.
Irish football, there's no skill in it, there's no flair, there's no pace.
I think it's a good thing just being able to see the players.
Does the Irish League have an inferior image?
Inferior to the English Premier League, yes, but to other leagues we shouldn't be.
I don't think the Irish Premier League is as good as the English Premiership.
If guys are going along telling all their friends, you know, oh, it was a terrible match, or the conditions, the ground conditions are poor, the stadium, I mean, by that. That word of mouth can have people staying away from football.
You don't go to a cinema to watch bad movies. You go to see good movies and good actors, and it's the same with the sport.
So, how does a comparatively low standard affect the loyalty of fans?
If you're game enough to go down and stand in a place like Oma or Solitude, not El Tarson, for 2 hours and watch your team, you know what I mean? I mean, you have to have something there to love the club.
Some men are under pressure to go shopping or different other things, plus there's the golf and there's other activities that people can get involved in. So if the team's going bad, then people won't turn up. If it's going well, will they ever come along?
You know, I don't think a standard should affect how much they care about their side.
That's the fans, but how does the standard affect the players' dedication?
The dedication in England is much greater simply because the rewards are greater and because it's their job, it's their livelihood.
Well, I play for Fulham, Mike, so I was training every day of the week. Here it's only two nights a week for most players. So you'd be doing it day in, day out, you know, so obviously your game and everything will change.
Are players content in part-time football, or do they still dream of playing at the highest level?
Definitely, if you play football like week in, week out, and you're like competitive football, you'd always like to play at the top levels.
Although I'd like to be playing in England, like, you know, but playing to one of the teams that play me is a boy, like, so I'm happy enough.
Oh, definitely. I think everybody wants to play in the Premiership.
But what do the fans think of the players' commitment?
In the Irish League, it doesn't mean you're caring less, but you may be more dedicated in Premier League, because there's more pressures on you to do well.
Say maybe in my side there'd be only a few players who would actually play for the shirt in a Saturday.
I'm sure everybody's dedicated to the club at the moment, and you have to be to play for your shirt.
You can shoot all the boosts you want if you feel no you need to.
I mean, players don't need to be told that they're playing bad.
And there's a lot of English and Scottish players come over to the Irish League basically for the money.
There'll be less imports, less big name players from across the world who may be destroyed the league with their excessive demands.
High player wages, amongst other expenses, and minimal income, what lies ahead for the Irish League?
As the Premiership gets stronger, as TV gets stronger, I think you'll find that the fan base will roll away a little bit more. There needs to be less competitions, more emphasis on quality of competitions. The Ulster Cup, which is created certainly because for a sponsor. You also have the Ulster Cup, which doesn't have a sponsor. Why don't you have a Coca-Cola Ulster Cup?
Do we start looking at maybe having it on Sunday matches?
Rather than have two run-down stadiums nearby each other, why not pull resources together, sell the stadium to B&Q or Tesco, and build one big stadium, say one in North Belfast, one in the Dulcet.
Irish football needs to set up some sort of working committee to see where we're going, because if they don't, I mean, it's only a matter of time before some clubs go below.
There'll always be an Irish League, because there'll always be sufficient interest to maintain an Irish League. But what you will find is, you'll find that it will become more and more amateur. Some things that can be more competitive.
Who cares what the finance is like in Irish football, or how committed the players are? As long as people still dream of scoring at their local ground, there'll always be an Irish League.